So we're going to continue on. Now we're going to look at spacings of supports. Well, we looked at spacings of supports for PVC, steel wire armoured and mineral insulated cable, and that came out in a previous video, so you can recap that if you didn't get that lesson. We're now going to do the same in appendix. Can anyone remember which appendix the fixings was, or cable supports it says? Anyone remember the appendix? Obviously not.
E3.
Let's go with Appendix D until we think about which one it's in. So turn to page 143 of the on-site guide for me. And we're going to be looking at supports this time in conduit. So I am looking at that page just there.
Yeah.
Okay. We all got that one? Have we already made some annotations on it? Because I think we did look into that one during a previous lesson.
Yeah, I've got notes on mine.
Yeah. All got notes? Have you found it, Ed?
I have as well.
Okay. So column number one is really important to us. So column number one, which has caused some confusion. Somebody even said on the clipping one, when we did for cable supports of twin and earth, etc., they went, I think you've got it wrong, Gaz. People are missing that bottom line out, aren't they? So the first diameter is in column number one, up to and including which size?
16.
So we can clearly see that's now up to and including, yeah, 16. Yep. So this is talking about the diameter of conduit. I've highlighted the top of the page where it says it's for conduit, yeah? Just in case I forget when I come back, it's actually for students. So if I was fixing a conduit, it was 16 mil in diameter and it was plastic. Which other columns am I going to use as well as column number one for plastic conduit?
Four or five.
But what, it doesn't say plastic. What does it say?
It says rigid insulating.
And I think last time I just got us to write the word, did I not, PVC above it?
Yeah.
So we can clearly see that that one is PVC conduit. So if I said to you, you had 16 mil conduit, horizontally the supports would need to be at what intervals as a maximum?
0.75.
And at vertical?
One meter.
So that's the maximum. We can go more frequent. We can't go less frequent than those dimensions. If I said to you it was, let's go for 25 millimeter metal conduit, what's it looking now like for horizontal?
1.75.
Do we all see that? Up to and including, yeah, so we're greater than 16, but up to and including 25 is 1.75. And vertically?
2 meters.
How is it that we've got now 25, not 16, considerably bigger conduit, yet our spacings can now be further apart? What's that?
It's rigid. It's stronger.
Yeah, so as you look down each of the columns, whether you're in metal or plastic, etc., as you work down them, as we increase the size of the conduit, we actually increase the spacings between our fixings, which is not counterintuitive, but you in your own mind think, oh, you'd have to clip it more often. But actually, it's self-supporting. It's a little bit more rigid. The actual supports, whether they be in the metal, the rigid insulated PVC, or the last one says pliable. What do we mean by the word pliable?
Flexible.
Yeah, so often it's called copex on site, but copex is flexible conduit. So people will say to you, oh, I'm putting a machine in, a rotating machine, it's going to vibrate. I'm going to bring a piece of copex from the isolator or starter to the actual machine. It's actually going to be, in this case, pliable, and I wrote flexible above it. And I think you probably wrote flexible above it as well in your column.
Yeah,
but that is what people on site are going to call copex. Okay, so it's like they call it pyro when it's mineral insulated cable, etc. So that's really important. So we're going to use that table in a second, and you're going to fill that in your notes. Let's look at the notes, however, below that table D3. There's some really important bits in there for us. If you look at note B, I've highlighted the maximum distance away from a bend or fitting that I can have my support.
100 mil.
So it's got to be within 300 mil. Okay, so when you put a bend in or socket box switch, etc., you should have a saddle securely fixing it within 300 mil. And I've highlighted it. So I've highlighted that if you haven't done it already. And in C, it goes back to, I think, what Ed said to me earlier on. What was the diameter for the factor for the diameter?
2.5 times diameter.
And I don't make this stuff up because, again, it's in the on-site guide. So, again, to highlight that as well. Right, what I want you to do now is on your page 9, can you put the horizontal and vertical spacings for the maximum distance for these supports if it was metal conduit? So I want 16, 20, 25 and 32 horizontally and vertically for metal conduit, please. Right. Okay, well done, Dan. So you want to go first? If I had metal conduit and it was 16 millimeter diameter conduit, what is its horizontal and vertical fixings maximum distance between supports, please?
0.75 and 1.0.
Yep, so 1 meter. Well done. If we go next for John, if I had a 20 mil conduit, it's metal, vertical and horizontal maximum distance between supports.
Okay, horizontal 1.75.
Yes.
And vertical 2 meters.
Yep, brilliant. And Ed, if you jump down to 25 mil metal conduit for me.
The same, 1.75 and 2 meters, yeah.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, both of those encompassed in the same line. And then if we go for Tim, what if we had a 32 mil conduit?
It's 2 meters horizontal and 2.25 horizontal and vertical.
Yeah, brilliant. So we've used columns 1, 2, and 3 in there in order to work it out for metal only. We could have gone on and looked at plastic and flexible if we wanted to as well. So we didn't. Okay, the notes only required us to do that. So brilliant. Well done for that. So that goes back to a previous lesson where we looked at the supports of mineral, armoured and twin and CPC cables. Now we've now worked out what the supports are for maximum distances now for conduits. Are we happy that we could do that again if we were working towards our domestic installer and we had a site visit with us from the NIC, NAPIT, Stroma, or from us, that we wouldn't trip up and have a saddle maybe further than 300 mil from a bend, etc.?
Yeah.
All right. Okay, good. So we wouldn't have emphasized that as much perhaps in the classroom, but your next course, which will be the next one you start, I would imagine, will be the domestic installer.